Loneliness increases the risk of heart disease by 23%. Just one day of being lonely is equal to the damaging effects of smoking 14 cigarettes that day. So I'm going to tell you more about that in this video. I'm Teresa Elliott, and I call myself an isolation warrior because I'm passionate about finding more ways to end loneliness, and I believe it's possible if we work together as a community. Today in this video, I just want to show you in a few short minutes why we should take the issue of loneliness seriously. During the COVID pandemic, many people have been forced to become isolated, and this has put a much greater risk of loneliness on this big group of people. Prior to the pandemic, public health experts were already concerned about the increase in numbers of people who are suffering from loneliness. In terms of how widespread this issue is, in Canada, loneliness is affecting 2 out of 5 people, or 40% of our population. Studies of prolonged loneliness associated higher risk of premature death, similar to smoking heavily or consuming a large amount of alcohol a day. Just one day of being lonely is equal to the damaging effects of smoking 14 cigarettes that day. Loneliness increases the risk of many diseases. So, for example, loneliness increases the risk of heart disease by 23%, and it increases the risk of stroke by 32%. Another scary statistic is that prolonged loneliness can double the rate of cognitive decline or dementia. Cognitive decline happens because of multiple afflictions that are caused by loneliness, such as physical inactivity, symptoms of depression, poor sleep, elevated blood pressure, and inflammation. Bottom line about this is that loneliness is a social stressor which causes a stress response in the body, and prolonged responses to stress in the body cause inflammation, and the inflammation is linked to many diseases. So as the stress response continues to be triggered by the loneliness and the stress of loneliness, the body becomes desensitized to it, and it can no longer fight inflammation. And over time, that becomes heart disease, stroke, dementia, or other types of diseases, and ultimately a shorter lifespan. I think I became passionate about ending loneliness when I realized one simple idea. Loneliness is dangerous. A prolonged amount of loneliness is bound to cause cognitive decline, and if you allow that to happen, you are allowing the person to lose their ability to cope with the inflammation because their stress response isn't working properly. And in essence, you're allowing them to develop a whole plethora of disease and live in poor health, in deeply painful sadness and pain, and to ultimately die younger. If it were a different kind of disease, would we allow it to continue? If 40% of our population was working in a coal mine that we knew was fully carcinogenic, would we allow it to continue? Would we let all the grandmothers in our province swim across a river that we know is full of crocodiles? It's the same concept. We know what's going to happen to them. I know this video today has had a pretty dark theme, and I would love to be talking about something a little more fun, but I really believe that this is an important issue, and I really want to drive home that it's something we should be paying attention to. And yeah, this is the hard part because it's really sad. However, once we do start to get more people involved and caring and being aware of this, then I will be able to make videos about how we can help fix this problem. I hope I've been able to bring up some important issues about loneliness, and I hope it compels you to want to know more and to possibly join our fight against loneliness through our Isolation Warriors. You can join our Facebook group, Isolation Warriors. You can catch information on Bridge and Brighton, which is the website of the company that I've started for the purpose of fighting loneliness. Or you can connect with me And definitely tune in for more videos, because I'm going to be gathering information from all over, every source and all of the different organizations that are already involved, and just trying to make this a meaningful movement. So if you like this video, please hit subscribe and the notification bell so you know when I make a new video. So for today, I want to wish you wellness and wonderful human connection. And I'm going to peace out, your friendly isolation warrior.